Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah, brothers and sisters. And I hope that you are coping with fasting of Ramadan, which is our beautiful month. And I promised last time to speak to you about the brain. The brain. And you can see the brain in the title has got a name in hieroglyphics. And this name is known since 1700 BC. And before that it was known. So it's nearly the brain is known since 5,000 years. But what was known about the brain? The ancient Egyptians, you know that they used to mummify the body. And they used to go inside the body and look inside the skull, and they found this white little thing, which of course, after death, it becomes like juice. And they used to empty it and throw it and never use it. And everybody, or every human being, until very recently, used to think that we think with our heart. And one of the beautiful things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala referred to the heart sometimes in the Quran as a site of thinking. Why is this? And maybe there will be evidence in the future that the heart has got something to do with thinking. But one of the things about the Arabic language is called al-balagha. Al-balagha means you speak to people in a language that they can understand. So when the whole world thinks that the heart is the site of thinking, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was kind, and in one or two places he mentioned the heart as a site of thinking. But he wanted to teach us that the heart is not the site of thinking. There is something else called al-aql, which is the site of thinking. How could he introduce that to us? How could he explain that to us? And we didn't know what he meant by the word yaqilun. He mentioned aql in the Quran, and he mentioned it repeatedly. I will mention to you in a minute how. And we didn't know about the aql until the year 1700, that's from 300 years ago, when they accidentally put electricity on the leg of a frog, and the leg of the frog jumped. So they asked the question, is it electricity? Is it? And in that time we discovered the electricity, and everything was electric at that time. And when I speak about electricity, I will show you that it is Allah who taught us electricity. He is the one who showed us the lightning. And he is the one who taught us what electricity is. And I will explain that to you in future meetings. So, in the year 1700 and over, that's when this frog leg have jumped with electricity, that we started to think about an electric theory, the nerves and this sort of thing. But the first time that scientists have thought that the brain is the site of thinking is after 1800 in the 19th century. And in fact, the first tracing of the brain, like the ECG, EEG that we have now, is in 1929. So we didn't know the brain except 200 years ago. And we didn't know even that it is an electric bit of machinery except in 1929. So Allah tells us over 1400 years ago that the brain is the center of intelligence and thinking. And Allah showed us many, many of the functions of the brain in at least 46 verses of the Holy Quran. 46 verses. So the first part of the Quran, He asked us to understand the function of the brain. What's the function of the brain? To understand the Holy Quran, to understand what the Quran is about. And you can see many ayahs here. In Surah Al-Baqarah, أَتَأْمُرُونَ النَّاسَ بِالْبِرِّ وَتَنْسُونَ أَنفُسَكُمْ وَأَنْتُمْ تَتْلُونَ الْكِتَابِ أَفَلَا تَعْقِلُونَ. It means that you order people to be kind and good and they forget themselves. While you read the book, the Quran, don't you understand? Don't you use your brain? إِنَّا جَعَلْنَاهُ قُرْآنًا عَرَبِيًّا. We made the Quran in Arabic so that you can use your brain and understand it. لَقَدْ أَنزَلْنَا إِلَيْكُمْ كِتَابًا فِيهِ ذِكْرُكُمْ أَفَلَا تَعْقِلُونَ. We have descended a book to you, and can't you use your brain to understand it? And not only to understand the Quran, but to also to understand how Allah brings the dead to life. So in verses, فَقُلْنَا اضْرِبُوهُ بِبَعْضِهَا كَذَلِكَ يُحْيِي اللَّهُ الْمَوْتَى وَيُرِيكُمْ آيَاتِهِ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَعْقِلُونَ. Allah said, hit the pieces that's in Surah Al-Baqarah together and they'll come to life. And use your brain to understand all this. And in another verse, وَهُوَ الَّذِي يُحْيِي وَيُمِيتِ. He is the Almighty that gives life and death. And He is the one who controls the night and the day. أَفَلَا تَعْقِلُونَ. Can't you use your brain to think with? This is before we knew anything to do with the brain. And then also arguments that do not stand to reason. So, أَفَتَطْمَعُونَ أَنْ يُؤْمِنُوا لَكُمْ وَقَدْ كَانَ فَرِيقٌ مِّنْهُمْ يَسْمَعُونَ كَلَامَ اللَّهِ ثُمَّ يُحَرِّفُونَهُ مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا عَقِلُوا وَهُمْ يَعْلَمُونَ. He said, do you still believe in them? And they used to listen to what Allah said, and they used to hear it, and they used to change it after they have used their brain to understand it. That's again the brain to understand it. And they know. يَا أَهْلَ الْكِتَابِ. In Surah Ali Imran, لِمَا تُحَجُّونَ فِي إِبْرَاهِيمِ وَمَا أُنزِلَتْ لِلتَّوْرَاةُ وَالْإِنْجِيلِ إِلَّا مِنْ بَعْدِهِ أَفَلَا تَعْقِلُونَ. يَا أَهْلَ الْكِتَابِ means you, the believers on the Injil and the Torah, why you argue about Abraham and the Torah and the Injil have been descended on them? Can't you use your brain? أَفَلَا يَعْقِلُونَ. وَإِذَا لَقُوا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا قَالُوا آمَنَّا وَإِذَا خَلَّ بَعْضُهُمْ إِلَى بَعْضٍ قَالُوا أَتُحَدِّثُونَهُمْ بِمَا فَتَحَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْكُمْ يُحَجُّوكُمْ بِهِ عِنْدَ رَبِّكُمْ أَفَلَا تَعْقِلُونَ. They said, if they met the believers and they asked them things and explain things to them, why do you explain it to them? Don't you know they'll argue it back with you? Haven't you got brains to think with? كَذَلِكَ يُبَيِّنُ اللَّهُ لَكُمْ آيَاتِهِ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَعْقُلُونَ. Allah shows you His ayah, and I'll explain to you the ayah. Ayah is not only verse. Allah will show you the ayah, use your brain for it. And reflection of Allah's creation of the universe. If you reflect on the creation of the universe, how He created the heavens, how He created the earth, the changes of the day and the night, the ships that run into the sea, what Allah have descended from the water and from the heaven to us to create life on it, and the variation of the wind and the clouds which are between heaven and earth, all this you have to use your brain to understand. لِقَوْمٍ يَعْقِلُونَ. So the word يَعْقِل is the word that Allah introduced for us. And this is a picture to show you all this variation. What I explained to you about the smoke in the heaven, the creation of the stars, how is it made, the thunder, the ships that move, the animals that exist, all this are evidence that you have to only find by using your brain. One of the things that he also asked us to look at, that the land on earth is similar to each other. And it's got grapes, it's got palm trees, it's got many, many, many plants. And all these plants you like to eat, and yet they are all different, and they are all drank from the same water. They all irrigated from the same water. I mean, you put water on a plant and this becomes apples, and you put another, the same water on another plant becomes orange. Doesn't he try to ask us to use our brain to know why they are different? Is he asking us to study genetics and the difference in constitution? So look at all these beautiful fruits, and I'm showing it to you now in Ramadan. All these fruits and vegetables have all been irrigated with the same water, and yet they're all different. They all taste different, and we all like them and eat them. And also from the palm trees, from the dates and from the inab, you make saccharin, sugars, that you can also make it into alcohol. Allah also says, قَالَ رَبِّ رَبُّ الْمَشْرِقِ وَالْمَغْرِبِ وَمَا بَيْنَهُمَا إِن كُنْتُمْ تَعْقِلُونَ, that He is Allah of the East and the West and what's in between. And can't you use your brain to think? And He made the light, the night and the day, and the sun and the moon and the stars, all under your services with His command. Why? Can't you think? Can't you use your brain? I'm just trying to show you how frequent He mentioned the word brain. Use your brain and think 46 times in the Holy Quran. If you ask them, who drops the water from the sky and make rain? They say Allah. Say, why don't you thank Him? But most of them don't use your brain. Don't use their brain. Who brings life to the earth after its death? Again, this is another ayah for you to use your brain. How this happened and why it comes. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala descends the water on this, from the skies, so that He give you life. And He also causes the variation of the wind. And these are ayahs for Him and for people to think, ya'qilun, to use their brain. I mean, look at the wind. I mean, we have tried to be very clever. And I'm going to talk about this sometime in the future, about wind. The wind comes from nowhere. From certain areas, yes, on Earth. We know where they come from, but what causes it? And how it's initiated? How hurricanes start? How storms, tropical, starts? And all these winds that come up and down, Allah controls it. Can't we use our brain to think about this? He shows you the lightning. And as I told you, the first person experimented with the lightning by taking a rod and exposing it to the lightning, and he was shocked and died. And this way he actually proved that there is electricity. But the electricity came from Allah. If He didn't tell us and show us about the lightning, and we use our brain to understand it, we would have never discovered electricity. And that's the lightning. All a great big charge of electricity. And look in Surah Al-Mu'mineen that Allah created us from dust, and then later generation from a drop. And He continues the cycle until we die, become old and die. So can't we use the brain to understand why all this happening? And look at all the beautiful pictures of the baby in the womb. And this is the alaqa, the little thing that is hanging down from the womb, and just like a big button in the womb is the alaqa. And I will speak about that. I will speak about that in the future, and I will tell you that this is the first sentence, the first verse that descended on the Prophet, peace be upon him, اقرأ باسم ربك الذي خلق خلق الإنسان من علق. He created him from a blastocyst. And the word blastocyst is only known about 30, 40 years. And those who become very old and got Alzheimer's, can't we think? Can't we use our brain to understand what they are? And then there's other functions of the brain that only people with knowledge, the scientists, that can understand what Allah is, use their brain. And people have to use their brain to understand Allah's signs. And if we are called to prayers, people shake their hands with wonder why people can't, why do they need to pray? Again, can't they understand and use their brain? Those who disbelieve in Allah, in fact, have no brain because they can't think straight. And the brain shows the wisdom of preferring life to come to the real life now. That's why we pray. We pray, of course, for the love and satisfaction of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and for having a new hope that we will go in the life to come with great chances of being accepted by Allah. And this is another verse, more or less saying the same thing. And only those who live for the future and for the life to come are the ones with the brain. And another verse, فَخَلَفَ مِنْ بَعْدِهِمْ خَلَفٌ وَرِثُوا الْكِتَابَ يَأْخُذُونَ عَرَضَ هَذَا الْأَدْنَى وَيَقُولُونَ سَيَغْفِرُ لَنَا وَإِنْ يَأْتِيهِمْ عَرَضَ مِثْلِهِ يَأْخُذُوهُ أَلَمْ يُؤْخَذْ عَلَيْهِمْ مِيثَاقَ الْكِتَابِ أَنْ لَا يَقُولُوا عَلَى اللَّهِ إِلَّا الْحَقَّ وَدَرَسُوا مَا فِيهِ وَالدَّارُ الْآخِرَةُ خَيْرٌ لِلَّذِينَ يَتَّقُونَ أَفَلَا تَعْقِلُونَ. This is more or less the same verse where people mislead themselves and say that there is no life to come, and if they use their brain, they will definitely find the answer. And also, Allah have made things haram, like playing, gambling, drinking, all the big sins in the world are haram. Why Allah made it haram? We can only appreciate why He made it haram by using the brain. And each one of them will need a talk and a lecture, because why is it haram? I will talk about the lahm haram and lahm halal. I will talk about that in one of the talks in the future. And you will see why Allah said to us, don't eat the flesh of the khanzir, which we all now know that we are suffering from the swine flu, from the khanzir, and why is the khanzir has been forbidden on Muslims. So there are other verses, many verses, which proves to the human being that he needs to use the brain to prove all the facts and the truth about life. So more verses all come with the word ya'qilun, the use of the brain and the behavior. If you don't use your brain, your behavior will not be right. So there is no blame on somebody who is blind or who is limping or who is ill and so on. If you use your brain, you can find the excuse for these people and how they have to tolerate their handicap. And those who cannot understand and listen, and they don't understand what's said to them, they're just like animals. They cannot appreciate what is true and what is false. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they say that they don't fight you except in protected villages. And you think they are together, but they are not. Because because they are people without brains. Of course, referring here to the disbelievers. And in the Day of Judgment, they will be saying, if we were listening and if we used our brain, we wouldn't have been in hell. And the worst type of human beings are those who are deaf, mute, and they are not using their brain. Thank you very much indeed. The next time I shall be speaking about the serious functions of the brain, where the brain actually commands and controls the human being and all his action. Thank you very much indeed. Please have fitar mabruk and fitar happy, and break your fasting, and I'll see you tomorrow.